Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another video of Circuitizers. This is Ashwant, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can build a Raspberry Pi Zero hat like this one. So this Raspberry Pi Zero hat is an 18650 hat which is used to power your Raspberry Pi on the go. You can directly plug this on top of a Raspberry Pi. It can be worked with a Raspberry Pi Zero or any other versions of Raspberry Pi for that matter, and once it's plugged it will power your Raspberry Pi. And not only that, we have also added some external peripherals like a USB port which can be used to power any USB device, and a 3.3 volt and a 5 volt pin over here which can be used to power any other sensors that you will be using along with Raspberry Pi. So in this video I'll quickly show you how you can build this one, and stay tuned, we will also be giving away three of these Raspberry Pi hats along with the components needed to build it. So if you want to take part in that giveaway, stay tuned, I will let you know how you can do that. That being said, let's get started. Now, before we get into the video, it's important to announce the sponsors as well as the fabricators of the PCB that we are going to use in this video. It is 7PCB. So 7PCB is a PCB fabrication and assembly service provider. So the good thing about them is that they are one-step solution providers, meaning when you send your design to them, they can help you with components procurement, they will fabricate your PCB, they will assemble your PCB and send it directly to your doorstep. So do check out their website and try getting an online quote. It is fairly simple, just head on to their website and submit your design and you will get a quote under 20 minutes. Also, 7PCB has their fabrication facility both in China as well as in Canada, so they'll be able to cater your needs across the world. So yeah, the name is 7PCB. Get into their website www.7pcb.com and do consider giving them a try. Okay, now you're looking at the complete schematics for our Raspberry Pi Zero hat, and trust me, it is very very simple, yet it is very very useful. So as I told you, there is nothing much on the top. All you can see is the 18650 cell, a button to turn on and turn off, the long header female pins which can be used to mount your hat on top of a Raspberry Pi Zero or Raspberry Pi 4. So this hat was actually designed for Raspberry Pi Zero. As you can see, it says Zero hat, but it will work with any other Raspberry Pi as well. So it will go directly on top of your Raspberry Pi, and after that you will still be able to use all the GPIO pins of your Raspberry Pi from here. So these are the long female headers, and then we have the USB over here and some external headers. On the schematics you can find the same, you can see the TP4056 charging and protection module, you can see the 18650 cell holder over here, and then the switch over here which can be used to power the entire schematics or turn off the power, the long female headers over here, and the USB port over here. So that is all on the top. On the bottom side is where all the work actually happens. So the thing is, the 18650 cell nominal voltage is around 3.7 volts, but the actual voltage would be anywhere between 3.2 volts to 4.2 volts. And as we know, our Raspberry Pi operates on 5 volts. So we need a DC to DC boost converter, which is exactly what you're seeing here, which will change that 3.2 to 4.2 volt from this 18650 cell to a regulated 5 volt. So this is the DC-DC boost converter, and it is based on the IC MT3608, which is very popular boost converter, you might have already heard about it. So basically how it works is that it has the MT3608 IC, which you can see over here. This is the brain of the boost converter. What it basically does is it monitors the output voltage. We have to set what should be our output voltage using these two resistors. The formula to set the output voltage for this IC is Vout is equal to V reference into 1 plus R1 by R2. So in our case, we need an output voltage of 5.2 volt. So we have set R1 and R2 at 1.2 kilo ohms and 150 ohms. So basically this IC can be used to source up to 2 amps of current, which is very well enough for our Raspberry Pi if you're not dealing any complex computational tasks or powering any much of sensors, displays and peripherals. And you can also see that the maximum voltage this driver or this boost converter can provide is 5 to 28 volts. But we are going to fix it at 5.2 volts using these two resistors over here. So basically what it does is, as you can see, this IC has a pin called feedback pin, which checks what should be the voltage on the output side. We have set it to 5.2 volts. And to maintain this 5.2 volts, it will switch the input voltage. So to maintain 5.2 volts here, irrespective of what voltage is here, the IC will switch, and because of the switching happening, there will be voltage stored in this inductor, and it will build up the charge and it will also discharge. That way it will boost the voltage, and this IC will control its switching frequency in such a way that the output voltage always remains at 5.2 volts. Now I'm not going to get in details on how the charge is stored here and how it is being discharged, but this is fairly how this IC works. All you have to do is connect it in this fashion and make sure you're choosing the right resistor values over here. Apart from that, we have some capacitor over here to filter the output voltage, a diode here to make sure that the current always flows in forward direction, and one of the important component here is the inductor, which actually stores the charge and discharges it. This is the way how this IC manages to boost the voltage. So you can see the diode over here and this inductor over here, and some filter capacitors which are used to remove any ripples. Apart from that, we are also providing AMS 1117, which you can see here, AMS 1117 3.3 volt, which will convert this 5 volt to 3.3 volt. Again, we have two capacitors over here to just filter the ripples out. So this 3.3 volt will be useful if you are using a sensor of 3.3 volts. So what we are doing is we are trying to avoid the voltage regulator present on the Raspberry Pi and get the complete power from this 18650 cell itself. So as I told you, this is the entire schematic. This is how the thing works. Just get the board, get the design, choose the right values, fabricate your board, and you're all good to go to have your own Raspberry Pi based PCB power hat. And for this video, we have used 7 PCB to fabricate all our PCBs. As you can see, the quality of the PCBs from them is really good. I didn't find any problem. All the wires, pads, everything was neatly fabricated. The silk screen looks perfect. So all I did was I sent my PCB design Gerber file to 7PCB and placed an order with them. And within few days, I received my PCB in a neatly packed box. As you can see here, it says 7PCB.com. And my PCBs were of very good quality, as I showed you earlier. And I straight away proceeded with assembling the components and testing it. So yeah, if you want to get these fabricated by yourself, you can get the Gerber file from the link given at the description of this video, and you can head over to 7PCB and try placing an order with them. So that is it, guys. This is how the entire schematics works. Okay, now time to announce how you can participate in the giveaway and win this PCB. So all you have to do is click on the link shown here. You'll be taken back to our website Circuit Digest, where you can enter your details and tell us where you will be using a Raspberry Pi based power hat. For example, I can think GPS tracking would be a very good application for this board. But what else do you think? Let us know. And for the best three answers, we will be giving away the PCB as well as all the components needed to assemble this PCB and few other goodies from Circuit Digest. So tell us your answers and get a chance to win this PCB. So that is it, guys. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you liked it and learned something useful. For more videos, click on the subscribe button and do stay tuned. We have more interesting projects coming up. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye bye.